Mathematics will fall first, to being solved by AI, that is, said François Fleuret on December the 3rd. Now, on December the 13th, DeepMind published this paper in Nature, having found new solutions in math and computer science with large language models, or short LLMs. How did large language models that are known to hallucinate and give so many bogus answers become such incredible math solvers overnight? That's what we'll explain in this video. So, how can it be that LLMs can make scientific discoveries when they are known to hallucinate and produce factually incorrect information? Well, let's remember that they are also quite creative at times. And there is a fundamental difference between everyday natural language problems and mathematics or code. Math and code have the great property of verifiability. In other words, once we have a correct solution to a math or coding problem, we know whether it is correct, as we see that the code compiles and that the result is what we expected. So, while LLMs produce piles of garbage, the pile comes with some nuggets of creativity. If there only was a way to decide which generations are garbage and which ones are genius. Well, there is this new idea in the LLM space of investing compute at test time after the generation. Suppose we have a problem formulated as an LLM prompt. Then we let the model generate a million answers. Then we let the verifier rate and rank these million answers. The verifier could be a test we have written, or even the same model that generated the answers, or another capable model. And yes, you heard correctly, even the same model that generated the answers would be quite good at rating its own answers, because quality estimation is much easier than generation. Think of it this way: it is much easier to say whether this solution is correct or not than come up with it yourself. And since math and code problems are verifiable, one can use such verification tests to rank the top solutions. And this is a recipe for how to select genius answers from a wide range of not-so-good model outputs. The key insight behind the idea of test-time computation is that the model has been training for months on internet-scale data and has achieved a certain amount of capability, so the capacity to perform a task, by transforming its inputs layer by layer and arriving at the answer. But to increase the competency, so the level of skill on a task, we could give it some thinking time during inference by letting it produce many answers, like a million, and rank those and let it make further computation with those. In other words, we are replacing the reasoning we were expecting from the model parameters with brute force computation at inference time. Now, how did DeepMind use this idea in their Nature paper to develop FunSearch to solve long-standing math and computer science problems? Well, because of what we said previously about code verifiability, you maybe are not very surprised that for solving math and computer science problems, they express them as code. First, the mathematician describes the problem in code and writes the tests that evaluate the problem to tell apart correct from wrong solutions. The mathematician also writes an initial program as a placeholder for the solution. By doing so, they specify the expected structure of the solution. So the whole thing is more like a skeleton, and it's useful to put prior knowledge we have about the problem in there. Then an LLM iteratively improves the initial program. In principle, the procedure could use any LLM working with code, but the DeepMind authors use Codey, which is a code LLM built on top of Palm 2. So now Codey improves this initial program by generating many, many programs, like a million. Not kidding, it's a million. And a lot of them are garbage, but some of them are great. The programs are automatically evaluated on many inputs by the test functions written by the mathematician. For each input, programs get a score, and the final score of the program is an aggregate over all inputs. Code that does not compile uses more memory or time than allowed, or does not deliver valid results, was discarded. But code that gets high scores goes to a program database. Then in the next iteration, FunSearch takes a program from the program database as an initial program, which is now better than the last initialization. Or rather, they use a couple of these best programs to few-shot prompt the model by showing it a couple of initial programs sorted by quality. With these input programs, they repeat the whole process of generating a million improvements, ranking them based on how well they perform on test inputs, and put the best programs into the program database, from which they sample the initial program in the next iteration again, favoring higher scoring and shorter programs. Okay, this was the method, but did they solve actual problems with this? Well, the authors wanted to solve the CAPSET problem and collaborated with Jordan Ellenberg, a mathematics professor at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, known for making an important breakthrough on the CAPSET problem. The problem is about finding the largest set of points, called a CAPSET, on a high-dimensional grid where no three points are on a line. What seems to be a weird graph theory problem is a model for other problems in extremal combinatorics, asking how large or small a set of objects can be. Famous mathematician Terence Tao described this as his favorite open question. The problem is extremely hard to brute force because the number of possibilities to consider becomes extremely large, super fast, larger than the numbers of atoms in the universe, which are 10 to the power of 82. And trust me, I've counted. Now, FunSearch solutions were programs that discovered the largest cap sets for some settings that were never found before. The authors say that this is the largest increase in the size of CAPSETs in the past 20 years. And the authors did not stop at the CAPSET problem and went on to the bin packing problem in computer science. Here the problem is to determine how to pack items of different sizes into the smallest number of bins. This has numerous applications in real life. Think of how to pack your suitcases when flying overseas, loading containers into ships, or loading data into your computer memory, or allocating jobs on a cluster. Usually, this problem is solved by heuristics devised by humans, but it is hard to find good heuristics for each specific situation. FunSearch automatically gave specific programs adapted to the specifics of the data and situations, outperforming human heuristics. Now, FunSearch helping make these breakthroughs is huge news. If you ask me, I was super impressed, and yes, maybe mathematics is a domain where AI can be already put to use, especially since verifiability is easier than with other domains. FunSearch has shown that one can usefully leverage imperfect and hallucinatory LLMs as long as one has the compute to produce a million of them per iteration and verify them. Jordan Ellenberg, the mathematician collaborating with DeepMind on the CAPSET problem, said that the solutions generated by FunSearch are far conceptually richer than a mere list of numbers. When I study them, I learn something. Which might mean AI will become a tool for mathematicians to aid their discoveries in the near future. Here's what the Fields Medalist Hugo Duminil-Copin said after I asked him about AI in mathematics at the last Heidelberg Laureate Forum in September 2023.
Question: how we will be creative? How these computers are going to be creative in terms of mathematics, beyond the question of whether you can understand concepts, which is still something that I think is a big challenge in for AI. So the creativity, it's a good question whether it's going to be able to replace us by being creative. In particular, how you would implement maybe the weaknesses of the mathematician that make it a creative person. I'm bad at computing, and this is a very good skill, right? Because that actually forces me to go around and try to find shortcuts. So on this point, I don't know if it's soon that we are going to be replaced. Now, in terms of helping, which is already something good, like to be an enhanced mathematician in some sense, it's a very good question. So far, it's not so helpful. If you take ChatGPT or things like that, it's completely useless for us, except for writing recommendation letters, apparently. But I still don't use it. But if you are honest as a mathematician, a big part of your creativity is emergent creativity. It's like you learn things, and out of learning those things, just something emerges. And so we are not so good at learning, where AI is very good. So if we can find, once AI will be able to recognize concepts and speak about concepts in a more efficient way, it may be that it's going to become a very useful tool for, this lemma that is still going to take me 2 months to prove, even though it's not the core of my paper, my argument. Well, this lemma, quite often, you know, you work for 2 months, you prove it, you put the thing on the archive, and then some guy or some girl from the other side of the world tells you, oh, it's funny, I proved this lemma in my paper from 1982. And you're like, oh man, if I would have known, that was 2 months that we would gain. This, I think there's going to be a big progress with AI, probably. It will be very helpful for this kind of speeding up the process. Checking proof, which is the last thing that people think of in terms of usefulness of AI, like of computers, can they check proof instead of us? It's a very interesting thing, but the cost that that it takes to actually transform the proof into something checkable is for now so big that it's definitely faster to ask people to check the proof in the first place.
Now, what do you think of FunSearch? Are you worried of AI taking over mathematicians' jobs? Should you now switch fields and give up mathematics? Well, it is on you to decide, but I would rather say that an interesting time is coming for mathematics and it might get very busy and vibrant there. It's not like AI will solve math by itself because these AIs are not independent. Remember, FunSearch needed the input of the mathematician and the problem description and tests to be able to work. But thanks to AI, you could make use of some programming skills and solve problems that you were not able to crack before. Thanks for watching this far. If you want to see more videos like this one, subscribe to the channel and see you next time.